Okay, let me go through a few more problems on the California High School Exit Exam, a few more strategies. You have the answers here, so you don't want to spend too much time on computations figuring the problems out. So Jana bought a car for $4,200, later sold it for a 30% profit. If I just do 30% as a decimal, 0.3, I multiply by the 4,000. It's not quite the same as 4,200, but if I multiply by the 4,000, I'll get $1,200 profit. 1,200 and 4,000 is 5,400. So I don't have to do all the computations to get the answer right. On the next one down, kind of the same thing. I have a $300 sale. A salesperson earns 2% commission. I convert that percent to a decimal. So 2% commission. On $300, so I just do that times 3, and I get 6, and I can see $6. Then I need to think, is that reasonable? For a 2% commission, that seems right as well. Quick review on exponents. If I have a negative exponent, it's a positive exponent in the denominator. So I can make that negative 4 a positive 4 in the denominator. So 2 times 2 is 4. Times 2 is 8, times 2 is 16, so I have 1 over 16, and there's my answer there. If I'm dividing with exponents here, I subtract. So if I have 10 to the negative 2 over negative 4, I have negative 2 minus a negative 4. The way I remember these is like a little guy on a diving board, jumps off the diving board, breaks the surface of the water. Negative 2 plus 4 is 2, so I have 10 squared. 10 squared, there's my answer right there. Another rule of exponents, when I'm multiplying numbers, I add these exponents. So this is going to give me 7 to the negative 2. There's my answer there. Which fraction is equivalent to 5 6 plus 7 8s? Well, I know I need a common denominator. That's going to work here. Let me go through some numbers. 12 will work for this, but not this. 18 will work, but not for this. 24 will work for both of them. So I'm going to have to get this to 24. I have to multiply by a 4 over a 4. That'll give me 20 over 24. To get this to a 24, I multiply by a 3 over a 3. That gives me 21 over 24. I add across the top to get 41 over 24. I keep that common denominator. There's my answer. So you want to look at your answers on these problems before you even start working on them. You want to mark up the test as much as you can so that if you run out of time and you move on and go back to that problem, all your work's still there. And be thorough. Go slow enough that you don't make any careless mistakes. All right, high school exit exam.